Hello, I'm Ty Mason from the diabetescouncil.com, researcher, writer, and I have type 2 diabetes. Today, I'm going to answer the question, is xylitol good for diabetes? But before we get into that, make sure you download my free diabetes management book, which also includes a diabetes grocery shopping guide, foods to eat and avoid, by clicking the link below. I'm going to be very honest with you right now. It has been my experience that anything I have consumed personally that ended in itol has ended in bad situations. There are some things that itol does to me, both involve me not feeling very well and spending long spells in the nearest restroom after consumption. With that being said, I had to do some research on xylitol. By the name itself, I already knew it was a sugar alcohol. The suffix itol is a dead giveaway. But is this particular sugar alcohol any different from sorbitol or mannitol? Well, perhaps we should start by examining what a sugar alcohol is, or better yet, what it isn't. Ironically enough, a sugar alcohol is neither sugar nor alcohol. Does that make sense to you at all? Well, there are basically water-soluble solids found in plants and berries whose carbohydrates are altered through a chemical process. The common sugar alcohols, such as sorbitol, maltitol, and erythritol, are derived from cornstarch. Xylitol is manufactured from birch wood waste, corn cobs, and the stalk residue from sugarcane. Yummy! Well, basically, sugar alcohols are low-calorie sweeteners used instead of sugar in many foods. These can be purchased and used in baking, for coffee or tea, cereal, anything you would put sugar on. A sugar alcohol like xylitol will add sweetness while delivering less calories. So is xylitol good for diabetes? Well, yes and no. Xylitol and other sugar alcohols are natural. They are not artificial like Splenda or aspartame. The body breaks them down rather than just letting them pass through. There are some disadvantages to sugar alcohols as well. They're not calorie-free. Always check the nutritional value on anything claiming to be low sugar or no sugar added. Many of the food products containing sugar alcohol still have a significant amount of carbohydrates, calories, and fat. Sugar alcohols also, in many people, like myself, have a laxative effect and can cause other, gastric symptoms. If you have never eaten anything with sugar alcohol in it before, you may want to try it at home first. I hope this has answered your question, is xylitol good or bad for diabetes? Don't forget to get your diabetes management book by clicking the link in the description box below. And as always, let me know if you have any diabetes-related questions. Thanks. I'm Ty Mason.